वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स एंड लर्नर्स, यू आर वेरी वेरी वेलकम टू केमिस्ट्री एक्सप्लेन्स। सो वी आर विथ अ न्यू वीडियो। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न फिशर प्रोजेक्शन एंड सम इंटरकन्वर्जन फॉर वेज टू फिशर, सॉ हॉर्स टू फिशर एंड न्यूमैन प्रोजेक्शन टू फिशर। सो these are the projections, different type of ways of representing an organic compound to in organic chemistry, as you will learn in it in class 11th. So we will start with first with Fischer projection. So as you can see on the slide how the Fischer projection look like. As you can see, the structures of monosaccharides consisting of D galactose, D mannose, and different type of these. As you can see it, how Fischer projection look like. So without wasting your time, we will first start with our Fischer projection, as it is a name suggest. It consists of one horizontal line and one vertical line. As you can see it, so as you can see that it consists of if you consider compound having ABCD atoms at four positions, and AC at the vertical position, BD at the horizontal position, and as you can see that it having a carbon atom at the center, and they are 90 degree to each other. Okay, as you can see it is the horizontal and vertical both are 90 degree to each other, and also the point is mentioning that the central one is a carbon atom. Okay, as you can see it, the central one is a carbon atom. So how to represent it in a Fischer projection? Okay, so let's start this. So basically in Fischer projection you have to consider the atoms that will lie in a horizontal plane will lie in a Fischer projection above the plane. Okay, so I repeat once again, the atoms lying in a horizontal line will lie in a Fischer projection above the plane, as you can see in the slide. Okay, as in BD are lying in a horizontal plane, name is in a B, and another one is in a D, so they are lying in a above the plane, but A and C will lie below the plane, as it is they are in a vertical plane. So they are horizontal and a vertical are 90 degree to each other, as you know. So this one is A and this one is C. So as you can see it, A, C and B and D are 90 degree to each other, and A and C will lie below the plane or out of the plane. So let's see this structure, how will you represent it in a Fischer projection form. So as you know the rules, that the atoms at a horizontal position will lie above the plane. So let's try this one. As you can see it, the atoms lying at a horizontal position will lie above the plane, as you can see it, HOH, and the atoms lying in a vertical position will lie below the plane, FN fuel. So this one is in a way of representing an official projection. So as you can see, I repeat once again the concept: the atoms lying at an a vertical position will lie in a below the plane, and same one for horizontal one. So what will be the trick for it? Trick will be for a horizontal plane, H for horizontal, it will be hug. So basically you have to hug, so you have to come with your hands to hug the anyone, someone. So basically it will be basically an out of the plane, as you can see it, B and D. So as you can see, it is in a basically in a trick. So the atoms lying in a horizontal, they will come in a position that it will seem to like in a hug, if you are hugging someone. So as you can see it, I am revising the concept that the atoms lying in a horizontal plane will lie out of the plane, and in vertical plane it will be in a horizontal plane. So let's go to the next one. So let's start with first let's see the Sawhorse conformation and Newman conformation. So let's start with this concept. As you can, in a Newman projection, it is basically in Newman, there is a different type of positions, like in a staggered position, eclipsed position. So basically, as you can see, the different type of positions in which. So as you can see, it is basically a Newman projection, and it's a bond line template also mentioned here. And another side, Sawhorse projection also mentioned, how it will look like in Sawhorse projection. So basically in Sawhorse projection, basically you can rotate the bond also in it. So you can make it in a eclipsed conformation also, and it also in other conformation also by rotating the bond. So let's go to the next one. So we will start with an interconversion of wedge dash to Fisher, Sawhorse to Fisher, Newman to Fisher. These are the basically a different type of interconversion. These can be helped in any competition exam in you. So let's start with first one is wedge dash to Fisher. As you can see, in a compound is given. So basically it is in a wedge dash conformation. So we will learn it with some trick. So basically from between C and D, you have to place your eyes and look at it in your from there. So as you will see it, C and D is coming towards you, as you can see it, but A and B are going away from you. As you can see it, A and B are going away from you, but C and D are coming towards you. So from this you can make an idea, so how to make its Fisher projection. So for making and basically its Fisher projection, by looking from C and D, as you can see, C and D are coming towards you. So they will come at a horizontal position and coming towards you, means it is an above the plane and coming towards you. Okay, as you place your eyes between C and D, so now A and B are below the plane because they are going away from you, as you can see it. So basically A and B will lie on a vertical plane. So you can represent by it also on a bond line template, also by representing A and B on a vertical plane and C and D on a horizontal plane. So simply the rule is you have to place your eyes between C and D and look at it. So as you can see it, that C and D are coming towards you, so you have to place it in a horizontal plane. So let's learn sawhorse to fisher. So as you can see it, sawhorse conformation, so as you can see it consists of an A, B, C, D, E, F. So basically the rule is in for sawhorse the compound should be in eclipsed conformation. As you can see it, the compound is already in eclipsed conformation. If the compound is not in eclipsed conformation, you have to place it in a eclipsed conformation. So the rule is that you have the compound should be in eclipsed conformation. As you can see it, the compound is already in eclipsed conformation. So let's if the compound is will be not in eclipsed conformation, so by rotating the bond you can make it in a eclipsed conformation. So let's place your eyes between from that where you can see the between AB and DE. As you can see A and B and D are coming towards you, so they will come on a horizontal line, but C and F are going away from you. As you can see it, so they will lie on a vertical plane. Okay, so let's represent in a fisher form. So let's see how it will look like in a fisher form. As A and B are coming towards you, so they will lie on a horizontal plane, and above the plane also same for D and E. So and as you can see A and B are represented here. So now for C and F, as you can see for C and F they will lie on a vertical line as they are going away from you, so they will also now below the plane. So let's one next one example is if the compound is it in staggered conformation. So as you can see it, if the compound it will not in a staggered gun, if it is in a staggered conformation, not in a eclipsed conformation, so you have to basically the rotate the bond, the common bond between the two carbon atoms, to make it in a eclipsed conformation. So by rotating it, as you can see ABC is rotated such that you can rotate it in anti-clockwise sense or in a clockwise sense or in a anti-clockwise sense. So as you rotate it, you will get it in a eclipsed conformation. As you can see it will convert it into an eclipsed conformation. So as the compound is converted into eclipsed conformation, now it will be easy for you to go to convert it into a fissure projection. As you will be, it will be an easy task. As the rule suggests, you have to place an eyes between that which are coming towards you. So the atoms that are coming towards you, you have to place it in a horizontal line, and the atoms that are away from you, you have to place it on a vertical line. As you can see it in a slide in this. So on a vertical line F and C will come, and on horizontal D E B A B will come. Okay, as you can see. So let's learn Neumann to Fisher. Neumann projection, as you can see it, it's look like can somewhat similar to an sawhorse. Okay, so the condition here is all the same, it will be an eclipse conformation. So as you can see it, you have to place an eyes between that one which are at a coming towards to you. So as you can see it, it look like similar to an sawhorse projection, but the difference is the way of looking. You looking this compound, if you look this compound from one side it will look like sawhorse, but if you look like from different side it will look like Neumann. So how to convert it into a fissure? Thus it look like similar if you have to place your eyes between that are coming towards to you. So you have to place that one in a horizontal plane or in a above the plane. So as you can see B, A and B will come on a horizontal line, also D and E, and C, F will come on a vertical line. So as you can see we learned wedge dash, sawhorse to fissure, Neumann to fissure, these are the different ways. So let's learn some other one. So let's learn that there are some different types of positions. First one is, as you can see, eclipse conformations, in which the different atoms are not parallel to each other. Okay, as you can see, front atom, back atom in eclipse conformation. Another one is the staggered conformation, in which they are not at there is a difference between two different atoms, they are not parallel to each other. Okay, as you can see it consists of a front atom, back atom. So let's see sawhorse and Neumann representations of two butanol. Basically there we are mentioning two enantiomers of it. So as you can see they are in a staggered conformation, not in a eclipse conformation. But for converting into a Neumann you have to consider it eclipse conformation. So basically I was showing an example. Okay, as you can see how it look like in 3D in eclipse conformation, sorry, it in a Neumann conformation or in sawhorse conformation projections. So this is an energy diagram, as you can see, of in a compound. Different are formed. First one is eclipsed, but there is a difference between two eclipsed. First one is CH3NH, another one is in a different one but having in a same energy. Okay, also consisting of gauge form and also anti-periplanar and a gauge form. So these energies are represented. So as you know how to convert it from sawhorse to Neumann, it will not in a hard task for you. So basically I want to tell you some points that, as you can see, in anti-periplanar its stability is the most. What is the reason behind it? So as you can see the reason behind it that CH3 and other one CH3 are anti-planar, periplanar, they are 180 degree to each other, so there is a minimum repulsion between them. And in other conformation, as you can see, there two CH3 are in a different angle to each other, so they are basically having some repulsion. They are not having a minimum repulsion. In anti-periplanar form there is a minimum repulsion, as you can see it. Okay, another point I have to mention that if there is a hydrogen bonding possible, okay, then eclipsed form will become, or sorry, syn periplanar form, or in a if okay, also eclipsed form and gauge form also become stable if there is a possibility of hydrogen bonding. So we are on the end of our video, as we have discussed different type of projections. So there is a good news for you. Chemistry Explained is coming with an new series of J Advanced solutions of different subjects like physics, chemistry and mathematics. So we will try our best to give you, provide you know, best solutions for that, and we will discuss also some basic tricks also behind there also for that. So let's end this video. Okay, at last I will say, and I jab you.